looking at Amadea's work, the most obvious precursor for this sort of work is Monet, and particularly his water lily paintings. When you look at a painting in blue like this with this deep ground, it's very reminiscent of the diffusion in Monet's late paintings. And you can trace it through also, you can trace it through to certain tendencies in modern abstract painting like Clifford Still, Helen Frankenthaler, Morris Lewis. You've got this sort of a tooth to the brush strokes where she's underpainted with ochres or olives and then overpainted in blues or grays. And when you stand back and look at it, it gives you a sense of surface quality that's not unlike wood grain. And that lends a nice formal contrast between the open saturated color and the sense of surface that you get from the grain. And finally, it's about painting. It's about the dialogue between different sorts of surfaces and different tonalities. A lot of the richness comes from her reducing her palette to one or two colors and then exploring the tonal relationships within those colors. She's obviously somebody who's got a lot of natural gift for color and a lot of love for painting.